Hey everyone, in this tutorial we're going to go through all of the basics of using iClone 8, from animating your character's face and body to getting your scene set up and doing a final render. iClone is a comprehensive and intuitive 3D tool that allows you to do everything from animation to scene setup and rendering. There's a lot to talk about here, so let's jump into it. Let's start off by ensuring that we have the standard workspace enabled, which you can find under the Window menu. If your workspace is a bit messy, you can click on Reset Layout to revert back to the default settings. The first thing that you'll want to do is add some stuff to your scene. iClone has a ton of free embedded content that you can access from the Content Manager, and everything used in this video comes free. You'll want to ensure that you've already downloaded all of the packs in the Free Resource folder. Let's explore the Characters pack first, where you'll find your basic embedded character model, as well as limited eye and teeth options. Let's apply our boy Kevin to the scene, which is the latest character model iteration that has all of the latest capabilities. A quick and easy way to immediately improve your scene visuals is to use one of the Lightroom presets in the Scene and Effects pack. These presets all include custom light setups for various scenarios, and as you can see, there are a lot of them. Each embedded character will include a perform menu that you can access by right-clicking. I'll just apply the simple motion first to show an example. Additional embedded motions for both body and face can be found in the Animations pack under Free Resources. iClone has an exceptional facial animation system, which we'll explore a bit more later, but for now, I'll simply apply a facial motion, which includes lip sync and expression.
Hi there, I'm a digital character created with Character Creator. And as you can see, I can act, talk, and have lively expressions. I look forward to being part of your upcoming animation works.
Okay, let's start from scratch and look at how we can further edit an applied body motion. After I apply this idle motion, I can enter into the timeline in a few ways, or just use the F3 hotkey. You can see the idle clip in the motion track, and you can zoom in and out of the timeline, as well as use the Set Start End Frame to Current Selection, which will set the entire project length to that of your idle clip. Let's look at how to customize our motion further by using the Edit Motion Layer tool, which you can access from the Animation menu at the top. The Edit Motion Layer tool allows you to intuitively tweak and adjust your character's motion by utilizing IK and FK technology. If you press the reset button, it will reset your character's entire motion back to the default value from the motion clip that you're editing. The Edit Motion Layer tool is great for creating your own custom animations from existing base animations, and allows for comprehensive frame-by-frame detailed editing to help you do so. We have a more detailed tutorial that goes into more depth on this tool on our Reallusion courses page. You can see in this sped-up example that you have control of hand gestures as well. If I go to different frames of the animation, I can make certain tweaks to the arm positioning and gestures to create an entirely unique animation. I can also easily move around the keyframes throughout the clip to adjust the timing of these gesture changes to my liking. Okay, that's a brief overview of applying motions and editing them with the Edit Motion Layer tool, so let's move on to the various other tools available for facial animation. I'll start by accessing the AccuLips tool from the Animation menu, which is used for automatic lip syncing. Here I'm using a pre-prepared audio file, but you can also live record your voice or use text-to-speech or script files from Reallusion.
You can import a prepared script and get more precise lip syncing.
The transcription may not be 100% correct, so you may need to make some edits for complete accuracy. After that, click Align and test out the result.
You can import a prepared script and get more precise lip syncing. Create incredibly natural speaking, like a real person, with a co-articulation design, and be able
to- If you're satisfied, just click Apply. From there, we can enter into the timeline and find a clip in the Viseme track that contains our lip sync data. There are tons of ways in which you can further enhance and modify your lip syncing result, so be sure to check out those specific tutorials on our Reallusion courses page.
You can import a prepared script and get more precise lip syncing. Create incredibly natural speaking, like a real person, with the co-articulation design, and be able to further fine-tune every word's visemes and strength level.
Let's take a look at another quick and easy way to animate your character's face, the Face Puppet tool. This is probably the fastest way to animate your face, as it creates expressions and animates facial features in real time according to your mouse movements. You can select any one of the many available profiles according to your animation requirements, then hit Preview and Space to test out how your mouse movements affect your character's expression or a specific facial feature. We'll choose one dedicated to Kevin and ensure that we click on the mouth and jaw to ensure that our facial expression for those features doesn't interfere with the lip sync that we've already recorded. In this case, I'll hit Record since we want to record the result.
You can import a prepared script and get more precise lip syncing. Create incredibly natural speaking, like a real person, with the co-articulation design, and be able to further fine-tune every word's visemes and strength level.
It's really that easy in iClone to quickly generate complete animations using these powerful real-time tools.
You can import a prepared script and get more precise lip syncing. Create incredibly natural speaking, like a real person, with the co-articulation design, and be able to further fine-tune every word's visemes and strength level.
Okay, now we have our basic character animation. Let's look at how we can save what we've done and merge it into other projects. In the Custom tab of the Content Manager, you can simply hit Save at the bottom. There are many different categories to choose from, but for our purposes here, we're just saving the entire project. You can right-click on any item in the Content Manager and select Find File to navigate to the folder in Explorer. Okay, let's look at how we can merge elements of two projects together now. I have this demo project loaded up, and if I want to bring in elements of the project we just saved, I can go to the Merge Project from the File menu. Here, I'm going to deselect the Shadow Catcher and Sky, as they have a high probability of compounding on each other, but keep all of the lights, and obviously also my character, then hit Merge. Now we have a much nicer environment for Kevin's TED Talk here. I can multi-select the items from the merged project and move them around to a more suitable area to test out the results.
You can import a prepared script and get more precise lip syncing. Create incredibly natural speaking, like a real person, with the co-articulation design, and be able to further fine-tune every word's visemes and strength level.
Okay, let's move on to doing a bit of camera animation and switching. We can create a camera from the Create menu at the top. When doing a camera animation, it's important to note the timecode position because a new keyframe will be generated each time you move the camera at a different frame. So if we move down to frame 257 and pan our camera up a bit, it will automatically create that animation between those two frames.
You can import a prepared script and get more precise lip syncing. Create incredibly natural speaking, like a real person.
If we open up the timeline, you can see the single keyframe in the transform track, which we can move around to either speed up or slow down the camera movement.
You can import a prepared script and get more precise lip syncing. Create incredibly natural speaking, like a real...
I can also adjust the camera position at frame 1 as well.
You can import a prepared script and get more precise lip syncing. Create incredibly natural speaking, like a real person.
A cool touch that we can add here is depth of field, which you can activate by clicking the Activate box in that section of the Attributes tab with your camera selected. To choose your focal point, simply click on Pick Target and then pick your character. If you do it away from the first frame, then you'll have a sort of fade to that focal point.
You can import a prepared script and get more precise lip syncing. Create incredibly natural speaking, like a real person, with the co-articulation design, and
if you want to switch between multiple cameras throughout the duration of your project, you'll need to use the switcher track. Here I'm just setting up a couple of other cameras with different positioning, animation, and depth of field effects. You can see the switcher track in the timeline under Project. Once the cameras have been set up, ensure that your camera view is set to switch, then right-click at any point on the switcher track in the timeline and select the camera you'd like. Here, I'm just going to make three camera switches at various frames.
You can import a prepared script and get more precise lip syncing.
Again, you can easily adjust the timing by moving these keyframes around.
Natural speaking, like a real person. person with a co-articulation design and strength level. You can import a prepared script and get more precise lip syncing. Create incredibly natural speaking like a real person with a co-articulation design and be able to further fine-tune every word's visemes and strength level.
Okay, now that we've got our basic project set up, let's look at how we can render it. I'm going to select Render Video under the Render menu. I'll use the most common format, which is MP4 in this case, and use the highest quality settings. 60 frames per second is the default frame rate for iClone, which we'll keep it at for now. For best quality results for a final render, you'll want to choose the Final Render option here so anti-aliasing can be enabled, which will decrease jagged edges that may come up in your renders. If your project has depth of field effects like this one does, also be sure to enable that. Finally, double-check your output range to ensure that it covers all of the frames that you'd like to render in your project. And that's a brief summary of some of the main features in iClone 8 to get you started. You can see how quick and easy it is to generate your own character animations, complete with scene background and lighting, in just minutes. Again, we have more detailed videos on specific tools on our Reallusion courses page, so please check those out to learn more. Thanks for watching, everyone, and I'll see you in the next video.